Eurozone, and I am a type 1 diabetic. Okay, so everything affects my blood sugar, whether it's food, exercise, stress, anything you can think of, it affects my blood sugar. So I have to keep continuous control of my blood sugar, because if not, there can be serious complications, whether it's from a low blood sugar or a high blood sugar. If you have continuous high blood sugar, there's eye complications, kidneys, foot problems, and so on. If you have low, there's a whole list, which I try not to get into, because it stresses me out, which causes my blood sugar to rise. So you see the difficulties. At the moment, I work at the Lean Hospitality Foundation, where I help people with disability to integrate them back at work. I meet them, I see what preferences they have, what skills, competencies, and so on. And then I work as a job coach as well, where I'm with clients at the place of work, so I can help them get used to the task. I'm also involved with the Maltese Diabetes Association, and in fact, I'm going to go for an internship at the International Diabetes Federation in Brussels for 6 months as well, to continue working for people with diabetes. So, I've been diagnosed since I was 3 years old, so practically I don't know a life other than that with diabetes. At the beginning, I hated it, and hate is not a strong word of how I felt. Then when I was at university, my brother got diagnosed as well with diabetes, and I started kind of working more towards working at the association, creating information sessions, planning activities, and so on. And I saw that I'm making a difference for those who live with diabetes. And also, I always kept in mind that I didn't want anyone to go through what I went through, because at my time, being from Gozo, it was considered as a taboo. So my parents, usually they used to tell me, you have nothing wrong, you can live a normal life, and so on. And they encouraged me to do anything that everyone else is doing. But when you go kind of a step outside, you find different responses from people. So, for example, I used to go to a bar and ask for a Diet Coke, for example. And he used to laugh at me, tell me, oh, you're a bit of Diet Coke already. And it used to affect me in a negative way. So kind of that lack of awareness, and also having a lot of people around me who are being affected by this condition, it gave me the motivation to continue and work into creating awareness, supporting others, and so on. My next step is going to Brussels, so for the internship, where I can kind of have a hands-on experience at working for a foundation that works for people with diabetes, whether it's creating awareness, supporting people with diabetes, and so on. So that is actually my next step, and kind of for my future plan, I wish to continue to work in this area, because when you go through the same experience as another person, that you have kind of that added experience and knowledge, because you're in the shoes of that person already. So you can understand, for example, when a teenager is going through the rebellious stage, for example. So you can understand, but at the same time, you can help them, give them information to make them live a better and healthier life to avoid any complications. Not at all.
Not at all.
From the organization, no. Living with diabetes, it creates a lot of, for example, characteristics which I think they became even more strange, because for example I need to keep control of my blood sugar. So whether it's having reports, keeping up with my levels and so on. So I became very much organized. In fact, for example, at work I want everything organized in order to have a successful project. I became more responsible because it's kind of like you have to care for your health as well, and you already have the stresses. For example, I'm still 23, so I just finished university, so you have the stress of university exams, peer groups and so on, so you have that stress already, and then you have to cope with a chronic illness like diabetes. So it's kind of an added stress, which at the end I'd like to think that it makes a person stronger. Well, being diagnosed at 3, I've went through, for example, the child stage where your parent takes care of you, and then I went also through the teenage years where I didn't want to tell anyone, not even my friends. It took me 2 years to tell my best friend that I was a diabetic, because I thought that she was going to find that too much and that no one wants to be friends with you and so on. So I understand the point where someone can say that he doesn't want to show that he has a condition. But at the same time, for the sake of your health, there needs to be a person that knows, because if, for example, at school you have a low blood sugar, when you're having a low blood sugar, for example, in my case, I start to lose concentration, I start to see very blurry and so on, and it's kind of losing control of your own body. So when you're losing control, sometimes I'm not even able to take out my meter and check my blood sugar. So it is important that at least a person from the group knows that you have this chronic illness. Nowadays, most people have something that hinders their certain capabilities. So whether it's me, whether it's someone else, someone is going to need help. And even though they need help, they do not need the same help which you give to certain people. So for example, one individual may need full-on support, whereas the other one, if you're just present and you are there to answer their questions, it's enough. So I think as a job coach, you need to adapt your methods according to the person. Being a job coach, you have the task, so you have to focus on the task, but at the same time you cannot forget the disability that affects the person, because the person is living with his condition every day. So if you're not passing through that condition, you don't know how it affects the person emotionally, for example, or physically. So you need to adapt according to the person. So I think it is important that before you start coaching the person, you start to get to know him or her, whether they need, for example, certain support, whether they need you to carry their file, for example, and so on. So you need to adapt according to the person, but at the same time you need to focus on the task as well. So I think job coaching is very much different from mentoring, and from my experience, I'm just as a job coach. There's no limit where a person can can arrive to. So if you have a person who has the idea but is not motivated to continue on that idea, it is important for that motivation, because no person has limits. I mean, yes, there are certain limits, of course, but you need to provide all the help you can give for the person to succeed. Because at the end of the day, I mean, it's very satisfying to know that you helped a person succeed and fulfilled his dreams or her dreams. I think the most important thing is to remember that yes, you're going to find bumps in the road, but you cannot give up, because at the end of the day, you have only one life and you have to try your best to succeed. And do not be afraid to seek help. Everyone needs help once in a while. So, I mean, you're not going to be the first one and you're not going to be the last one. It is important not to give up, because if you have a dream and you think that dream is going to help, for example, other people, or is going to bring a difference in society, I think it is a dream worth working for. Okay, so a week before my university finals, for example, I got diagnosed with diabetic retinopathy. That's where weak veins start forming in your eye and they start to burst. So for example, I cannot lift any heavy objects and so on. So for example, one time there was someone coming at home with a delivery, and I opened the door and kind of I was still at the beginning of my diagnosis. And he said, "Oh, you'll help me with the boxes, right?" And I said, "No, I cannot lift, sorry." But at that moment, kind of, I wanted to help, because the person couldn't see the problem. But at the same time, I couldn't do it, because I know that if I'm going to lift, for example, a box, it's going to cause a problem. Most people, when they see, for example, a person, and if they don't see certain things, they're going to think that nothing's wrong and that you can do anything. Whereas, for example, speaking for myself, I'm always thinking about what can affect my blood sugar. For example, if I go for a swim, okay, so I need to check my blood sugar before. I need to see if I need a snack. I need to see if it's too high, if the sun is going to cause a high blood sugar, and so on. A person, when you see him, you don't think that every step that a person has to take, he needs to plan before. So, for example, I used to work in an office, and I used to go, for example, I used to sit down and so on. And you have, for example, 8 hours at a desk. For my diabetes, it wasn't that ideal, because 8 hours at a desk, your blood sugars are going to go high, because there's no form of exercise and so on. I used to hate it, because I know that people are going to see me as a normal girl and they don't know that there's something wrong. But at the same time, I didn't want to tell them that there was something, because I hate going to a person and saying, "Oh, I have diabetes."
So now your aim is to create awareness about this disease, especially when it affects young people.
Exactly.
So people at least will know more about it and its symptoms.
There are a lot of children these days with diabetes, whether it's type 1 or type 2. And I mean, it is important for the sake of their health, because everything that you do, I'm going to do as well. So for example, if you go for a walk, I can go for a walk. I can go out with my friends, I can go to parties, I can travel abroad and so on. I can do everything, just I have that
more preparation.
I need to prepare, I need to plan and so on. So I have that added stress, kind of. So since it is a hidden chronic illness, a lot of people don't really understand that a person has to plan and prepare for the day. So for example, I remember when I used to hang out with my friends, they used to come up with a spontaneous sleepover. I couldn't do it because I didn't have enough supplies on me at the time. So at that time, I used to say, no, I have to go home. So I know it is hidden. I know that I'm not going to go out and put a label on my shirt or something that says I'm a type 1 diabetic, because I want to live a normal life. But at the same time, I think there's lack of awareness as well. And it is important for people to know, because nowadays the number is increasing, unfortunately, and it's affecting more people and more families as well.